What is up, guys? Thaddeus here. We are back with another video. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Thaddeus. I do a lot of stuff, but I usually teach dropshipping. Now, in this video, what I want to actually do is, because I know a lot of people with Shopify, especially just the industry around Shopify, everyone's so focused on products, products, products. And I haven't seen very many people talk about actually selling like intangible goods or services on Shopify. So I want to kind of bring that out there and show that to you guys as a potential selling point, something that you guys can do for your own Shopify stores, right? So what I mean by that, because I know the title, right? I say like non-products. What I mean by that, just to clarify, right, is technically it is still like a product, but it's intangible or it's like a service, right? Which can be classified as a service. And what do I mean by that? So we're gonna hop in a screen share real quick, just so I can show you guys an example of one that I just found for you guys, just to kind of give you guys a quick walkthrough and show you guys what that is, okay? Just fucking starting the screen share. 3, 2. Fuck, my battery's about to die too, man. Fuck this. Okay, hold on. All right, we got the camera battery back on. Now, so if you guys will notice, I'm on this website right now called VIP Social, and this is just something that I found online that basically is doing exactly what I'm saying you guys could actually do, right? I think you guys might be able to do it actually a little bit better. But as you guys will see here, this is a Shopify store. You know, just to validate that, at the very bottom it says powered by Shopify. But what this store is actually doing, they're not selling products, guys, they're actually selling services. So they're selling packages for Instagram growth, okay? And what that does is, again, so it's not necessarily like a product, right? They're not drop shipping a product. They're basically marketing a service, but just on the Shopify platform, which is something that I've seen a lot of people kind of just not touch on or avoid. So, and they're actually using the same theme I used for my very first Shopify store. But again, guys, this is just something that I want to kind of like break down and show to you guys as sort of like an alternative if, you know, you're not actually having luck drop shipping, or if you're having a lot of problems fulfilling with Oberlo, or you can't find USA suppliers, right? Then maybe perhaps what you should look at doing is selling an intangible product, okay? Because again, an intangible product, guys, is anything. It doesn't necessarily have to be a service, okay? It can be digital, it can be, you know, an online, it can be an ebook, anything like that, okay, guys? But again, it's still just a medium, because again, Shopify is just a platform to sell things online. But most people now, they think of Shopify as a drop shipping platform, right? Which is not entirely the case. So again, what you can do with this, guys, again, a lot of this stuff, right? For example, an ebook, something like, you don't have cost of goods, okay? Your cost of goods is just like little to nothing, because there's no actual price tag associated with, you know, for example, like an ebook, okay? Because if you're selling that, right, for example, if you sell an ebook for $9.99, it doesn't cost you anything. It costs you time to actually make the product in the very beginning, but that time isn't attached to every single specific purchase. Whereas, you know, if you're drop shipping, right, if I'm selling bracelets or something like this, you know, it could cost me, you know, $2.50 on AliExpress, another $2.50 for an e-packet. So again, my total cost of goods is around $5. I might sell it for $20, whatever it is that I'm doing, right? Because then you have, you know, different margins and calculations for that. Whereas, you know, if you're selling an intangible product or service, you don't have any of those problems. The biggest thing, again, is just marketing and traffic and how you're branding whatever you decide to actually do. So again, I think branding wise for this particular service here is not that good, just because I feel like they kind of just slapped on a theme, threw on some pictures. Again, this picture is very, very pixelated. Again, it's like I always advocate for like custom content and taking a particular marketing angle when you are launching something like this. And again, even the domain, like a .vip domain, and their name's already vipsocial.vip, I don't think is very good, I'd say. But again, I just want to walk you through this and just make you guys aware that there are other options out there for you guys to just, like, you know, to make money as a side hustle, to launch something, just in case, you know, you're not thinking of selling products, or you don't want to sell products, or you just want to know about the alternatives of this. Okay, so with this video, again, it's not very, very long at all, just because I just want to make this something quick and just informative for you guys. But again, if we're looking at something like this, okay, as you guys can see, like in a drop shipping store, if you're actually selling, sorry, that's my Google Chrome extension just to show you guys. But again, oh yeah, with this, you can actually see what apps and stuff there they got going. But look at this too, it's like their whole branding has changed as well. I clicked one link and we went from, let's go back. If it wants to go back. So we went from a black and white sort of theme, right? They looked a little bit dark. They're using some gold text here to kind of give off that luxury presence, okay? But they're not doing it too effectively. And then if I clicked one of these things, I don't know which one I clicked, this one, VIP Social, Okay. And then it goes straight from a blue color, like we went from black and white to a blue kind of theme. They immediately kind of killed the branding, and they're using a stock photo here for Instagram instead of getting custom content and taking a branding angle, okay? And this picture is way too big. It doesn't show anything on the bottom of this website, all right? And it is a terrible sort of like product image, okay? But what they're doing here is, look, so basically they have an app called Recurly or some other recurring form of app on their Shopify store to make this a recurring service, okay? So again, I talked about ebooks, I talked about services, but another thing you can do on Shopify, right, is having a recurring sort of business model where, so they're selling this one, this platinum package for $200, okay? And I'm guessing it's billed, okay, yeah, recurring subscription billed monthly, okay? So when that's, what that's actually doing, guys, is again, that's letting them basically try and get a customer and keep them for a long amount of time. So again, with my SaaS projects or with my softwares, right? This is something that I'm really, really, really familiar with in terms of like customer, your churn rate, and stuff like that, where it's like, what is the lifetime value of a customer? Because again, this goes into marketing side of a recurring service or product, right? So for instance, if they're trying to get a customer to pay $200 now and then $200 every single month, if you can figure out how many months an average customer lasts, like for example, say, they spend $200 a month, right? But an average customer only stays 3 months, okay? So that's 200, 400, 600. So on average, you can make $600 per customer that you bring into your program, okay? But if you're doing that, right, then that means, okay, if I can get $600 out of every customer, right, then that means even if I have to spend $300 to get a customer, I'm still profitable in the long run. Which is a lot of, like, it's something that a lot of beginners don't really understand, is that, like, the key to marketing or to beating out your competitors is being able to spend more money to get that customer and then make money off of them on the back end or in the lifetime value of them, okay guys? So I know that was a little bit of like a marketing lecture for you guys in terms of just a recurring business model, but again, so this is just something that I wanna like just bring to light for you guys. Cause again, it's a very, very quick video, and I just wanted to kind of like, again, shed some light on something like this and a business model that you guys can look at. So again, what that means is like, so we're not drop shipping, okay? But you could do a ebook, you could do anything intangible, okay? A downloadable good, something recurring, right? Can you offer something of value or offer something, a service, right? That someone would want to use continuously every single month. Anything like that, okay guys? And that's what a lot of people kind of don't really look at. It's sort of like the underbelly of of Shopify, if you kind of think about it. But that is the video, guys. Again, just want to make a very quick video and kind of just show you guys a potential business model. You guys don't have to actually dropship if you're not trying to dropship, but actually want to still be, you know, in the space. But yeah, that's the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure to leave a like. Make sure to drop a comment. I respond to everybody's comments. And don't forget to subscribe, guys. I will see you guys in the next video. Again, check all the links down below if you're interested in the Ecom Challenges dropshipping program. That's down there as well. I haven't talked about it publicly. Like, I haven't announced that it's actually live yet just because I'm still adding videos to it. But it is almost there. You guys can get it now for early access. It's cheaper. But that's the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoy. And I will see you guys on the next one. Take care. Peace.